Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. My name is Lindsay with FlexiFuse, and today we're going to show you how to make this ice cream cone. This is made out of fabric, and of course there is FlexiFuse fuse on the back, and today we're going to use this 25 sheet package of FlexiFuse. So let's get started. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started on this project. Right here we have our pattern with our cones and our ice cream pieces here, and these red pieces are just so you know that this is what needs to be cut out, because this will be underneath it as a shadow. So we have this 25 pack sheet of FlexiFuse, and all the instructions are on the back, and we're just going to follow right along there. So we're going to take our piece of FlexiFuse, we just have this sheet here, and turn on this light box. This is a daylight light box. And we are just going to start tracing. Now you're gonna wanna trace on the paper side of the FlexiFuse. The back side is going to be rough. That's the glue. So make sure that you are tracing onto the paper side. And you can use whatever marking utensil you would like. Today I'm going to be using a Sharpie. And it's not going to bleed through, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, and then we are just going to start tracing. Alright, so we've now traced all of these on. As you can see, it didn't bleed through the back. You can only see it just because it's a dark marker and it's a thin sheet of paper. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to trim these out. And we're going to want to make sure to leave a margin around them. So these right here are all going to be on the same color of fabric, as well as these. So instead of trimming them out in all these tiny different little pieces, what you can do is go ahead and just trim around the whole area, and then that's going to save you a lot of time in cutting. So we'll go ahead and do that, and then we'll trim these ones out separate, making sure to leave a margin around them. So next we're going to fuse these. So we're going to match our corresponding fabrics here. And then we are going to move over to our ironing board, and we're going to iron these down. And what you're going to do is you're going to take the iron and heat it to a cotton setting, no steam. And I'll show you on this. What you're going to do is you're going to cut out a piece just slightly larger than this, and you're going to lay the glue side down onto the wrong side of the fabric, the back side. So that way they are touching. And then you're just going to press your and hold your iron on it for 5 to 8 seconds, and you're going to repeat until the entire piece is fused. So we're going to go do that, and then we'll come back to you with these pieces. After you get them ironed down, they're going to look like this. And you're going to have the fusible fused to the backside of your fabric. Excuse me. So then what you're going to do next is you're going to take your little pair of scissors, and you're just going to start cutting along the outline. And you're going to do that for the rest of your pieces. all of our pieces are now cut out and the FlexiFuse is on the back. So what we're gonna do next is we're going to take our pattern here. This is gonna be kind of like our layout guide in a sense. And we are going to peel off the paper backing of the FlexiFuse. And as you can see, the FlexiFuse is left on there and it's even and consistent and really thin, and it's gonna be so easy to sew through. So if you want to use a light box, you can. If not, we're just going to lay this under our fabric here. And then we're going to take our pieces and we're just going to line them all up here. Just like that, making sure to take the FlexiFuse off the back. And then once we've laid all of our pieces down, we can go ahead and iron them down. You're welcome to iron them down piece by piece. It's whatever is easiest for you. So we're going to take ours over to our ironing board, lay all of our pieces out and iron it down, and then we'll come back to you with the finished product. All right, so we've laid out all of our pieces and we've ironed them all down. And just to remind you that you want your iron on a cotton setting, no steam. You're just gonna press and hold for 5 to 8 seconds. And if there's more fabric, like the thicker layers of fabric you have, the longer you're gonna wanna hold, just so that it all gets fused down. And we fused it with this paper underneath, and as you can see, it didn't burn the paper. I mean, it got kind of like a little yellow, but other than that, it was fine. So you're welcome to pin that down, that way it doesn't move, and then you can put your pieces on there and iron them down. So now we have this cute ice cream cone, and we just put it on a fabric background. But you are more than welcome to put it on anything you like. You could put it on a wood plaque. You could put it on a dish towel, some paper, whatever you like. We can't wait to see what you guys come up with. And be sure to follow us on our Instagram at FlexiFuse and to tag us in your posts with the crafts that you've made using FlexiFuse, and we would love to share them. Thanks for watching.